discuss with two of my friends, parents in a Jewish school that they soon will come here to the stage, is to rethink a little bit of this concept of that a Jewish school is only for the Jews, which obviously it's mainly for the Jews, but if we do not have Jews, the question is what happens with these schools.
My name is Tracy Vater. I am originally from Curacao, which is actually an island on top of Venezuela. It's an ex-Dutch colony. I was raised as a Protestant, and when I was 19, I believe, I converted to Islam. That's why I chose to go to put my children to King David. The father of my children, his granddad is actually a Jewish. Where I come from, we have a lot of Jewish. We actually have one of the oldest synagogues in the Latin Americas. Very known to have sent on the ground, on the floor of the synagogue that was actually sent original from Sinai to remember the exile of Jewish, that they were in exile for 40 years. The main reason is for me to put my children in King David has to do for them to know their heritage as well, that their grandparents are actually Jewish.
I had my DNA tested in that, and although the family tradition and the genealogies that I've checked in Persian books from the 19th or 18th century traced it to Benjamin, my DNA testing showed that we're from the colony. So maybe we got lost, absorbed into that tribe as the priest that spread out with the tribes. So this is one of the reasons why I sent my children to King David School. I believe it's a unique school, and obviously I wanted to get in touch with my Israelite roots as well, which is why I chose King David.
Zakir came to me first time, probably was 2 years ago. He comes to me and he asks me, which tribe are you from? I said, well, actually it's a very good question, because I'm not a Jew. I'm a Levite. I'm not from Judah, I'm a Kohen. My tradition is that I'm from the Levite tribe. And he says, I am a Kohen too. They have a tradition that they are descendants of the people of Israel. And I brought Zakir once to our shul here in Birmingham. We had a title for Shavuot, The Lost Tribes. And Zakir came and said, well, we were never lost. We're here in Birmingham. The ethos of the school will be saved thanks to people like Zakir and Tracy. And because they send for ideological reasons to the school, they're not the only people that they found that say, we feel that it's Abrahamic religion, we feel that it's the same prophet, we feel that very comfortable in the Jewish school. I came out to one of the rabbinic conferences, and I shared this story, and I said, this is a school of Yemot HaMashiach. And everyone laughed. And I was the only thought, the one, at least that they publicly thought that this is a school of Yemot HaMashiach. The Jewish leadership needs to, first of all, realize that today there are more and more Gentiles that they want the Jews or the Judaism to lead. And the fact that we don't have enough Jews, it's not maybe the ideal situation, but on the other hand, maybe instead of thinking that we should close it, maybe we should look for other partners that we have that send for ideological reasons to a Jewish school to see what they have to say about this. And perhaps there is still a point to have such a school even without Jews.